can discipline desire, whether one can curb it, is a deeper question altogether, which is, what do you desire? What makes you itch? What sort of a situation would you like? Let's suppose, I do this often in vocational guidance of students. They come to me and say, we're getting out of college and we haven't the faintest idea what we want to do. So I always ask the question, what would you like to do if money were no object? How would you really enjoy spending your life? Well, it's so amazing. As a result of our kind of educational system, crowds of students say, we'd like to be painters, we'd like to be poets, we'd like to be writers, but as everybody knows, you can't earn any money that way. Or another person says, I'd like to live an out-of-doors life and ride horses. I say, do you want to teach in a riding school? Let's go through with it. What do you want to do? When we finally got down to something which the individual says he really wants to do, I will say to him, you do that. And forget the money. Because if you say that getting the money is the most important thing, you will spend your life completely wasting your time. You'll be doing things you don't like doing in order to go on living, that is, to go on doing things you don't like doing, which is stupid. Better to have a short life that is full of what you like doing than a long life spent in a miserable way.
Science Society the most is that there's such a range of drivers here. We've had MDU drivers, and we've had people who are just coming out for their very first time. And I think the best part about bringing those skill levels together is learning from each other. I mean, I've gone to a couple of the other events that we put on at the USAIR and learned quite a bit, and be able to bring some of that down here where drifting maybe isn't as popular. I feel like it's been beneficial for everybody involved. And Slide Society as a whole has grown exponentially in the last 2 years, 3 years that I've been involved with it. More cars, more people, more interest, and I hope it continues to grow.
I'll tell you. are kind of calm, I guess. And just back a couple of years ago, we were nothing but a couple of kids basically kicking the idea around of, you know, getting the track to really set us free and shit like that. And fucking flash forward like 5 years, and we're probably the biggest drift group in Wisconsin. I mean, it's really hard to think about, honestly, that we've come this far, that we've been able to really, like, sell out events almost, and that we've actually had this much reach into car culture just in the Wisconsin area itself. I mean, we pulled tons of influence, which, not trying to be, you know, arrogant or anything, but that says something, that, you know, when we go wherever and people know our name, that's getting on the impressive side of stuff for, you know, just a couple kids with some punk-ass attitudes.
We had, like, drift cars. We were like, yeah, drifting's awesome, man. Fucking hang out with this guy every goddamn day. In our Corollas.
I got this man his first nice Corolla. The Purple Panda.
Yeah. Yeah, I bought that shit from him. And you know,
that's how I got him started, because he wanted one, so.
So we just started drifting, like, you know, the winter and stuff like that. And progressed to, like, the rain, and we realized that shit didn't really work out so hot. With the 80 horsepower SR5s.
But then I got him his second Corolla.
Yeah. Everyone, like, started talking about how sweet it would be just have a track where we could go to and just drift and not be on the fucking streets and just, you know, just have it constantly out there instead of looking behind our shoulder the whole time.
Yeah, trying to set something up. And we always had a midnight runs on the weekend where we just go out and play around. Mm-hmm. And then we only exclude, like, only a couple people to come because we don't want all the little fuckboys.
Fuckboys? No, fuckboys.
You know, mess everything up, because those are the ones that, you know, just hang out and just try to follow us as fast as they can.
Yeah.
You know, that's where you get all the trouble from.
But anyways, I was, like, in school at the time, Corolla this. I think I just had a motorcycle. I was in between cars. And then everyone's like, we can start, like, we do drifting now on, like, Thursdays, like, for $15 every, or was it 10 or 15 starting off?
10.
Yeah. It was, like, 10 bucks every Thursday at Columbus 151 Speedway in Columbus, Wisconsin. And that was known as the Columbus 151 Speedway Drifters. That was a pretty sweet name.
Yeah.
Stickers and everything was official. But that was like five people. And that was just it, you know? And eventually, like, got hooked up with a, you know, decent Corolla, the same one I still have to this day. And I just started showing up. And just more people to the party. Like, when we first started doing it, like, we never really went to drift events before. We never saw anything. So, it was just like, we hit the one big corner and be like, fuck yeah, man, that was sick. Because a lot of people, like, you just spin out beforehand or anything, so.
And we usually just tell them, take your time, learn the track, make sure you're comfortable so we don't have to scrape you off the wall. It's no fun when nobody's having fun.
Yeah, and everyone took their time and it was good shit. And eventually we started seeing, like fucking Kyle Gilbertson, he had a 240, and he was the first guy to actually transition between both corners. And I was like, whoa, holy fuck! I was like, now I gotta get there. So we just started progressing and everything like that. And one time, just, who was it? Juan Marquez and Chris Hackinson. Fuck yeah, guys, you guys are shit. Showed up for practice one time, and you just went, you took lines we never even thought we could take at that track. It was sick. So then we just had more shit to look up to. We were just so stoked and just buzzing on that. So then we're like, cool, man, let's just take it to the whole next level. We'll be right back.
Louder, start over.
It's psycho, really? No, I don't know. It's like a really big family. The first time I came here, I knew nobody at all. And I think everybody was more excited when I like got out there and started drifting than I was myself, which is awesome. And there's Sam with a helmet. But no, it's cool because everything about the Slide Society itself, like, it's just a big dysfunctional family, and we all get along, we all help each other out, and there's so many levels that it's just exciting to see people grow and progress. So, I don't know, it's the fun of it.
Good luck.
the second largest, biggest family I have. It's a really dysfunctional family, kind of. But it's the most fun.
So sometimes there'd just be like one person, but we're still pretty tight and everything like that. And we got organized and started talking about shit. And they're like, Columbus 151 Speedway Drifters is like, we started getting more organized and we're like, we can make this way bigger, have other tracks and everything like that. So we couldn't just have a too specific of a name. So then we all just had a bunch of names. Like one was Yoshi and Friends, because Cam's son's name is Yoshi and he's like 14 or whatever. And he was already drifting. You know how to drift before he could drive. He was a little crazy kid. But Yoshi and Friends was like, you know, that was pretty close to being what we were going to be called. But so it ended up being, you know, Slide Society, right on my chesticles. And yeah, it's good times there. We slowly took off. And through the years, it'd be like, we have 50 members now. And at that point, I wasn't like a... I was one of the people who founded it, and I actually named it, but I wasn't the president. Drew Brom and Alex Schulze. Schulze, I fucking love you, man. Can't wait for your ass to get back here. It's good shit. But Schulze had to, he was in the military, and he had to go up to Alaska where he was stationed at, and he'll be coming back soon. But he was VP, and I worked my way in there. So I became the vice president, El Presidente, vice. And yeah, we started growing more and more. More people were coming to the events and started spreading the word. And we had flyers out. And, you know, Drew fell off. Just, you know, personal things. It happens. Life gets in the way. You can't dedicate all your, well, all your funds and everything into drifting. It's just ridiculous. Like, you won't go anywhere. Like, I mean, you could go where, but people do it. But sometimes you just gotta be an adult and move on to bigger and better things. So then I took over. And we just kept doing business as usual, and eventually we just started picking up more tracks. We still had Columbus up until last year, but we'd have events where it's 30 cars like tops, and then the year before this year, 2015, that was 2014, if you could do math, like we'd have 50 cars some days, and it just got hectic. You know, everyone started coming because we're like one of the only, we have the cheapest events, you know, it's really appealing, you know, it's a little circle track, they get in the walls and, you know, whatever, it's still drifting.